Now let us shift back to politics.
Yeah.
Poo Zoram Thanga has been known to many people in India since he came back from the jungles as a very effective, efficient peacemaker. And Mr. Vajpayee was very fond of you and he wanted. Do you have any role in any of the peace efforts now in Northeast or in the neighboring country of Myanmar? Because many people have looked at you as a very effective peacemaker or deal maker. I'm using deal maker because that's a term Donald Trump uses all the time. He loves deals. So are you involved in any of the peacemaking, deal making at the moment? Because that's another incarnation that people see you in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You see, when Atalji was the Prime Minister of India, peace talk with the Nagas was already started.
Right.
He sent one of the Indian emissary, Mr. Suresh Kausal, the former governor of Mizoram, as a emissary. So he went there. And after that, we had a discussion with Atalji. He said that, Atalji, peace talk is a little complicated, especially with the underground people. It is like trying to win over the heart of a girl. When you first meet the girl, and if you say that, do you love me? If you love me, let us marry. What would be the date of the marriage? If you start with that, and suppose you go to the underground people and ask them, what is your political demand? That should come last. It, date of a wedding should come last. The first thing I tell you, you have to tell the girl is that, how beautiful your sari is. You have to start from that. And so I told you he was laughing like anything. So he said, all right, I'll send you to meet the Naga underground leaders. I met them in Bangkok, and after a lot of talk with them and many meetings, I could bring them to Delhi.
So I know.
In Delhi, I brought them. I should say.
Earlier they were saying they will not come to India to negotiate.
But anyhow,
you brought them.
After a long talk, now the process is going on. That is one thing.
So they are going to sign the agreement, I'm told, soon.
Yeah. We have a high hope on that. And then the next is the Northeast. Almost all the Northeastern and the ground groups in Manipur, in Nagaland, here and there, whether it is in Meghalaya or Garo, or in with the Buddha people also. I help them to sit them together in the same table with the government of Indian representative. I have been doing that now also. I just returned from Delhi and the Prime Minister said that you are the only person with whom we can trust to make peace in the Northeast. So we'll give you a homework. Try to meet the underground people there in the Northeast. Of course, I've been meeting them many, many times all along.
I know.
But there are some groups whom they have not met it. So now, before you, one group also came. I had a meeting with them from Manipur.
Oh.
And then I am working on this.
These are Mar groups or Metis?
Mar groups? No. They are the Paite group.
Paite, okay.
Paite group are their Kuki. They are the Kuki group.
Okay.
The Kuki groups are there, Paite groups are there, Mar groups are there, these are groups.
So many.
And then even the Metis underground also. Prime Minister and Home Minister wanted me to contact those people and bring them to a negotiation table with the government of India. And I'm trying on that. So in this matter, meager as it may be, I'll try my level best to have peace here in the Northeast, to follow an example how we make peace in Mizoram.
Sir, they say that you cannot have long-term peace in Northeast if Myanmar is in trouble. So, there is a peace process in Myanmar also and nationwide ceasefire. I'm told that you have a role there as well. Some people are interested to learn from you the way to go forward.
Yeah.
Have you been in touch with the Burmese government on this or some of the groups?
In 2009,
right, sir.
The Burma underground group, their leaders, some of their leaders came to me here in Aizhou.
Mm-hmm.
They said that you please help us to make peace with the Myanmar government. Because we have been having a lot of peace talk with the Burmese government. And since we could not succeed, the Burmese government and ourselves, we invited the Chinese representative to help us in this matter.
Mm-hmm.
After his effort, he failed. He could not succeed. And
you
after
mean
the
Chinese?
Yeah, Chinese okay. emissaries.
Okay, okay.
And then we asked for the Japanese, and he failed. We asked for the United Nations, he came and he failed. And quite a lot of people failed. So we believe that you are the only person who can bring us to the table together. So we came to you. I told them, now the Congress is in central government, so they will not permit me to go to Myanmar and do these things. So as soon as the present NDA government comes into power, they came and contact me again. And so, all right, I'll go there, and then I went to Myanmar. And then I meet the chairman of a Myanmar Peace Mission, MPC, they call it, General Aung Myint.
Aung Myint, I know him.
Yeah. Also, with a lot of discussion, he said that Myanmar government also wanted to invite you to make peace with our underground people. We have been trying to contact you all along, but we're a little timid. But at last you came by yourselves. Maybe it's a God's arrangement, they said. Uh-huh. So we'll send you to Thailand to meet the underground leaders up there. And we'll give you all the possible financial help or anything. So they sent me to Bangkok. And then after that, I went to Chiang Mai. I met the Myanmar underground people many times. Like their General Ban La of Kachin. And like that, quite a lot of them, I met them many times. So I gave a report to the Myanmar government. They were very happy. At that time, the target was the Myanmar underground people said that we like to learn things. We'll come to Delhi. We'll come to India with the help of the Indian government.
Ah, okay. So Indian peace process.
Yeah.
They want to learn.
Yeah. So
okay, okay.
I report this back to General Aung Myint. He said that Myanmar government is also really interested in doing this. Let them have an exposure, the underground people.
Okay.
So I told them that now I came alone in my personal capacity. You know, before I went to Myanmar, I asked Doval, NSA, let us go together because we are friends. He said, no, I cannot go.
He's your old friend.
Oh, old friend. Go yourselves. We have not received an invitation from the Myanmar government yet officially. You go yourself. When you make the way wait enough for the government of India to come in, then we'll follow you. So I went there and I told General Aung Myint that Indian government likes to come and help you in the peace process. He said,
when was
greatly
this,
welcome.
When was this, sir? How long back?
I think I got all the records there.
No, but 2000, this is
2016, 2017, something like that,
okay.
Before it came to power.
Okay,
three years before it came
but
to power.
But BJP was in power in Delhi. But
they
you were not in power here.
Yeah, we are not in power yet at that time.
Okay.
So I told them about the government of India's willingness to come and help them. General Aung Myint said, let them come. We really welcome them. We really welcome them, he said. So I told Doval again. But the government of India said, between two governments, there has to be a written commitment or a written invitation. I told General Aung Myint again, and they sent a letter to the government of India, inviting them to help them in the peace process. And then at the time with Doval, we went together. I told Doval, now we are ready, let's go. So we went to Bangkok, met the underground leaders many times. And then after that,
this was also before you came to power.
Yeah, before I came to power.
Oh, okay.
And then after that, there came the nationwide ceasefire with the Myanmar government there. So in order to celebrate that nationwide ceasefire.
So you played a role in that?
Yeah. Okay. From the beginning. So they invited Chinese government, Japanese government, and then Thailand, etc., and the neighboring countries. They invited India also. So Doval said, since we are invited for the celebration of the nationwide ceasefire, let us go away. So I said, all right, let's go. So he brought his home ministry plane. And he picked me up at Calcutta. So he picked me up at Calcutta. We went there to Nipido. We witnessed that. And after that, we returned. But in order to follow that, political things have changed. There was election. Military government were no more in power. Aung San Suu Kyi was in power. Then it got some different period there. But now I understand that the Myanmar government, even Aung San Suu Kyi, is also really interested in this matter. But anyhow, by the end of this year, they are going to have election. And so And in the meantime, the Myanmar MP was kidnapped.
NLD MP.
NLD MP was kidnapped and kept him for more than 70 days.
By the Arakan army.
By the Arakan army. So Myanmar government thought that he might have died. But anyhow, they make a contact to me, say that if you can help us for the release of the MP, we shall be grateful because Arakan army are your old friends. Indeed, they are. And so I talked to them. Well, we thought that we will never release him. But once Mr. Zoram Tanga said so, we have no alternative but to release him. So they released him.
I know.
About a week ago. I know. Also.
I know you sent an emissary. I have information.
And
with your letter.
Yeah. Myanmar government is very happy. Aung San Suu Kyi was so happy.
One thing then I will ask you, since you have a good rapport with Arakan army, they are creating a lot of disturbance for this Kaladan project. They are kidnapping contractors and, you know, India is having difficulty in implementing Kaladan project.
Yeah.
Do you think you can sort this out by dealing with the Arakan army or there is a problem there?
Before I came to that, let me say that on the 20th of February this month, next month, February 20, it is the Chin National Day. They are going to celebrate then in the Chin Hills in Danglang. And so Aung San Suu Kyi's government and the Chin people invited me to come and attend the Chin Hills National Day.
What day is that, sir?
February 20, Chin National Day.
Okay.
And Aung San Suu Kyi...
So next month, basically.
Yeah. Aung San Suu Kyi, as well as the Vice President, Mr. Van Chiu, are intending to attend that. They also invited me to, but since it is a budget session, I cannot go there. I told them, I'm sorry. But anyway, I'll be coming to Myanmar in the beginning of April for the Spring Festival in Kalimiyo, in Dahar.
Okay.
So like that. Coming to the Arakan site also. You know, in the beginning, the contractor told me in Delhi that we're going to start from Mizoram this and that we shall be able to finish it soon. I said, if you can do that, it's well and good. But then I was doubtful and he could not do anything because Arakan army would not permit him. So I told the foreign minister, without me, you'll have a problem in going through this kind of war because Arakan army are my old friends. So without me, I'm doubtful that you can do it properly. And then together with the foreign secretary, we had a discussion this time also before I returned from Delhi. So they said that now we are going to substitute a new contractor and he will come to you and with your help, the Arakan army will not disturb
us. So this present contractor is going to go?
Yeah. He cannot work there. He has been going. He couldn't do anything because they are at loggerhead with the Arakan army. So they are going to have a new contractor. Float a fresh tender and then give it to a new contractor. So what the foreign minister and what the foreign secretary told me is that when everything is done, he will come to me and then help him. I'll try to help him with the Arakan army so that the work can be done. I am hopeful.
Okay.
Yeah.